So before we get into the video on laborers, we've just hit 2,000 subscribers on YouTube. So you know what time it is, it's giveaway time. Mainly to say thank you guys for showing me the support by subscribing, liking and commenting on my videos. So this is one way of me giving back to my community. So this giveaway is 15 million silver. And this time there'll be 5 winners. Why 5 winners you ask? Well, it's because I'll be giving away 10 Black Panthers. That's right, each winner will be winning 2 Black Panthers. Since in my last giveaway, that's what everyone was hoping to win. So here you guys are. To be eligible for the giveaway, all you have to do is be subscribed / subscribe to my YouTube channel, like this video and comment your in-game name with the text Black Panther in the comment. I'll be using a random YouTube comment picker and the target word will be Black Panther. So make sure you include that in your comment. The giveaway will last 2 weeks like the last one and will start as soon as this video goes live and will finish on 15th November midnight. So the winners will be drawn on the 16th of November. I will post the winners in the description, my Discord server and the YouTube community post. This way you have 3 ways of knowing if you have won. To claim your prize, all you have to do is message me in game or on my Discord and when I'm online I will give you your prize. If we are in different time zones, I will leave the item in the chest on my guild island so you can claim it that way. Also, I can't remember the name, but there's this one guy who hasn't picked up his prize from the 1k subscriber giveaway. If he doesn't pick it up before I draw this giveaway, I'll just pick someone again to win that prize. Now that that's out the way, let's get into the epic passive money making video. This is episode 16 in my How to Make Bank series. This is a series that will teach you different money making methods for Albion Online. So all you have to do is watch these videos, learn the money making method and start applying it yourself and you'll see your bank tab grow. If you have any methods you want me to check out, leave them in the comment section below and I'll see if I can make a guide on it. This video is meant to be about solo and group dungeons. However, to make money, you will need to faction flag and do the dungeons. Since the solo and group dungeons heavily relies on RNG on its own, I would not recommend it unless you're just starting. Any questions about this method or any other Albion Online questions, feel free to join my Discord and ask your questions there. Me or one of the other members will try and help you out. You can also pop in on Twitch. I stream every Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, so if you want to hang out, drop by and say hi. So a lot of you have been asking for this video. And when I'm streaming, a lot of you ask about laborers. Since that's what I recommend to everybody if you want passive income. Laborers are hands down the way I make most of my money. Once you start, you won't stop. You will slowly start building a labor empire. So let's get into the basics of how to set up this money making method. This method will require you to have some silver to invest upfront. For this method, you will need premium if you are doing the later steps in this method, since at the end you'll be refining and crafting to maximize profits. And you will need a player island for houses or a guild island for guild halls. Now to hire a laborer, you will need to have a house for that laborer. You can build houses on both player islands and guild islands. So if you have been following my guide so far, you will know how to get a player island. If not, check out my other videos to learn how to buy an island. So there are 2 ways you can go about setting up houses for your laborers. One is building a player island house, which can hold up to 3 laborers at tier 5 and above, or setting up a guild hall, which can hold 15 laborers at tier 5 and above. Both have their advantages and disadvantages. If you don't have any money to build a guild hall, then start by building a few houses on your player island. If starting money is not an issue, then I would recommend you build a guild hall. The reason you want to build guild halls is that it saves time daily when running back and forth between player islands and houses, since your laborers are in one space. It also saves you costs on furniture, we will discuss this later on the video, and guild islands give you more chest space to organize your items with the guild bank. Another reason I like guild islands over player islands is that you only need a tier 1 guild island to get its full benefits, while the player island you have to upgrade it to max tier to unlock enough building slots to build houses on the plots. My advice is go for the guild islands over the player islands if you can. If you have other characters that you would like to access your player island or your guild island, here is how you give access to someone. Head over to the signpost and then select what type of access you would like to give them. I don't recommend you give anyone co-ownership unless they are your real life friends or you know them well enough. Scroll down to the visitor and then type the player name you want to give access to your island. You can also give guilds and alliances access by switching this button here. Next, press enter or click plus and then press save. Let's move on to how to build a guild hall or a house on your island. To build a house, you will first need to place a blueprint on the island that allows you to build it. To do this, go to any land that allows you to build on it, press the H key, and then click on the house tab. Select the house you want to build and then align it on the land till it turns green. Left click and it will place the outline of the house. Now add the resources needed to build the house, and when you've completed it, your house will be built. Here are the costs of upgrading player island and a guild island. Also, the materials needed to build a house and the materials needed to build a guild hall. The material costs are the same, but as I stated earlier, if you can, try and build a guild island with guild halls. So now that we have set up the houses for the laborers, what are laborers? Laborers are NPCs that you can hire to work for you. You give the laborer a type of journal and it takes the laborer 22 hours to complete the journal and return to you. So you will have to do this every day if you want to see that epic profit. I recommend you pick a time in the day and do this every day at that time so you have a routine which will make you that passive income. I do my laborers and farms as soon as I wake up before going to work, so when I get back home I'm free to play how I want to. There are currently 11 different types of laborers in game. However, right now from my testing, only 5 out of the 11 will make you profit, the other 6 are not as good, and one is outright nerfed to the ground. So here are the 11 different types of laborers. Lumberjack, Stonecutter, Prospector, Cropper, Gamekeeper, Mercenary, Blacksmith, Fletcher, Imbuer, Tinkerer, and Fisherman. Each laborer has a journal that you can fill in different ways. Here is a chart from Albion Online Wiki that shows you what each type does and what they bring back. Lumberer, Stonecutter, Prospector, Cropper, and Gamekeeper are gathering laborers. You can fill their journals by gathering the resources associated with that journal in your inventory. So for a lumberjack, you will need to gather wood with a lumberjack journal in your inventory. Make sure you have the same tier journal as you're gathering, so if you're gathering tier 5 wood, make sure you have a tier 5 lumberjack's journal. Mercenaries were nerfed to the ground, and I don't recommend anyone having these right now in Albion Online in 2020 anyway. Who knows, maybe they'll get buffed later on in 2021. The way you fill mercenary journals is by PvEing while having the journals in your inventory. They are filled by getting fame. The 5 laborers we will be focusing on in this video are the Blacksmith, Fletcherer, Imbuer, Tinkerer, and Fisherman. These are the laborers right now that are going to make you the most profit. Fisherman laborers are the only gathering labor worth doing right now if you fish. More on this when the fishing how to make bank video comes out. The other 4 crafting laborers and their journals get filled by crafting the gear associated with that tier journal / laborer. To fill blacksmith journals, you need to craft warrior weapons or plate armor with the journal in your inventory at a warrior's forge. To fill fletcherer journals, you need to craft hunter weapons or leather armor with the journal in your inventory at a hunter's lodge. To fill imbuer's journals, you need to craft mage weapons or cloth armor with the journal in your inventory at a mage's tower. And to fill tinkerer journals, you'll need to craft tools with journals in your inventory at a toolmaker. So if you haven't started crafting, research what item makes the most profit and pick that laborer for that item in the city that has that crafting bonus. Each royal city has a crafting bonus if you craft the item in that city. Here are the bonuses for each city. This information can be found on the Albion Online Wiki. If you have already started crafting, then pick a laborer associated with that weapon or armor. Another good choice is to pick Carlion as your city since you can sell the loot to the black market. Now that all that is done and set up, let's move on to how to hire a laborer. To hire a laborer, head outside of your house or guild hall and find the small scroll icon with the feather. Then scroll down and you should see a list of different laborers you can hire and the cost to hire one. Pick the one that you want and then press hire. Next, move into the house or guild hall, find an empty space, and when the blueprint turns from red to green, left click to place the laborer. Click pay and you will see your laborer appear inside the house or guild hall. If you don't want to raise the laborer from level 1 and go through the process of leveling them to tier 5, I would highly suggest you buy laborer contracts off the market. A laborer contract is you buying an already leveled laborer that you can place in your house or guild hall and it will be good to go after they settle in. To place a contract, click on it in your inventory, then press place and then do the same as mentioned above. Now onto the most important thing for laborers. its happiness level. The more happy the laborer is, the more resources it will give you when they have returned. Laborers require 100 happiness per tier of journal in order to get 100% return rate on your journal. Anything below 100% and there's a chance that you will not get any resources back, only an empty journal. So how do you increase the laborer's happiness, you ask? Well, you do it with beds, tables and trophies. Make sure you place the furniture before you place the laborers, since that way it will take them less time to get max happiness. A trophy gives 3 laborers happiness, a bed gives 1 laborer happiness, a table gives 6 laborers happiness. So for a player island house, you will need 1 of each tier trophy up to that house tier, 3 beds of that house tier, and 1 table of that house tier. But if you have a tier 5 house, you want to have tier 5 beds, a tier 5 table, and tier 2, 3, 4, and 5 generous trophies. For a guild island guild hall, you will need 5 of each tier trophy up to that hall tier, 15 beds of that hall tier, and 3 tables of that hall tier. So if you have a tier 5 guild hall, you want tier 5 beds and tables, and tier 2, 3, and 4 generous trophies. You want to try and aim for 150% happiness, so that you get the maximum number of resources returned. To get 150% happiness, you need to have the house, table, laborer, trophy, and bed 1 tier above the journal you're using. So if you're using a tier 5 journal, you want the house, table, bed, trophy, and laborer to be tier 6 to achieve 150% happiness and get the maximum resource return on that journal. Make sure you place all the trophies in the house slash hall from tier 2 up to the tier of the house slash hall, since the trophy bonuses from the generous trophy stack. You should only get shark trophies and spyglass trophies if you're planning to do tier 8 houses slash halls, since you can't max happiness in a tier 8 house or hall. I think the max you can get is 122.5%. This is my house setup, and this is my guild hall setup. You can do this however you want. Feel free to do this in this way at the start if you don't know how you want your layout. Now that you have everything set up properly and you're ready to go, let's move on to making that silver. To start getting silver return from the investment, you will need to have your laborers at least tier 5, since tier 5 journals is where the profit starts kicking in. Anything after tier 5 will be more profit, but do keep in mind that the higher you go, the more expensive the journals will be if you buy them, and the larger the silver pool you will need to keep it maintained. From this point on, there are a few ways you can go about making profit. The first way is by giving your laborers journals and then selling the returned resources. The second way is to give your laborers journals, refine the returned resources and then sell them. And the final way is to give your laborers journals, craft with the returned resources into weapons and armor and then sell them for profit. If you have alts or other characters with premium, you can combine method 2 and 3 into one method. Give your laborers journals, with the returned resources refine them with one character's focus, then with the refined resources craft them into weapons and armor and then sell them on the normal market or the black market to make profit. This way you'll be maximizing your profit since you're pumping focus into each step. So the first way gives you low to medium silver return. The second way gives you medium to high silver return, and the third and fourth ways give you the highest slash best silver return. The reason why taking it a step further gives you more profit is because you are using focus in these steps. And the more you craft slash refine, the more specialization and mastery you will be getting in that tree. The more you have, the lower the focus cost. The lower the focus cost means the more you can craft with the same amount of resources. The more you can craft with the same amount of resources, the more journals you'll be filling. The more journals you fill, the less you have to buy from the market. Once you get to the point where you're self-sufficient in journals, you'll be making that bank. Now, there is no fixed income with this method since there are so many variables to take into account, such as tier of journals, laborers' houses, island levels, and mastery and specialization. However, what I can tell you is that it'll take around 4 to 6 months of doing this every day to recover your initial investment. After that period, it's all profit. So I have 3 characters that craft and refine each day with focus. I make around 3 million silver a day minimum, depending on journals and market prices. If you've been paying attention to the video in the background, you will notice that we have started with 3.93 million of estimated silver. And at the end of the video, we have 5.87 million estimated silver in our inventory. So if we sold the resources right now, we'll be making around 2 million silver. If you do method 2 and 3, it bumps it up to 3 million silver minimum, and depending on what quality you craft, how many books you fill, you'll be making even more silver. This example was with 162 Fletcherer laborers, 1 full guild island, and 3 full player islands. The guild hall and player island houses are tier 7 and I'm using tier 6 journals. All of my laborers are tier 8 since I've been doing this for some time. My character's crafting specs are around 350 out of 700, and the refining specs are 369 out of 500. I told you, once you start seeing that profit, you won't stop. You'll build a labor empire. This has been one of the longer how to make bank videos because I wanted to make sure I included all the information you will need to start this method for laborers. Good luck with everyone who participates in the giveaway, and I'll see you guys in the next Albion Online video, which is tier 7.3 Avalonian Dungeon. We managed to get 3 legendary chests. The loot was epic for some. It premieres in 2 days at 10 a.m. UTC. Thanks for watching!